Hello everyone, welcome to Concept Sera. Today we are going to discuss case set number 3, which is based upon letter decoding. So let's get started and try to understand what exactly given to us. In the diagram below, 7 letters correspond to 7 unique digits from 0 to 9. So there are 10 digits are here and we are having 7 letters. And the relation is given to us here, P into Q into R is equal to X into Y into Z, and finally Q into A into Y. And over that we are having 5 questions here which we can definitely decode if we decode this particular product. So let's put the given data in better manner so we can make you understand how to solve this particular case late. So here we go. Here we are having 10 digits and 7 letters. It means 3 digits are extra. So we have to decode which 3 digits are extra and we can remove those digits. So with the use of the given product, as we know, these products are equal to each other. So definitely we cannot use 0 anywhere. Because if we use 0, maximum we can make these two products equal to 0. But we cannot make this product equal to 0. Because if Q is equal to 0, then these two products are equal to 0. But this product will not be 0 in that case. So 0 we cannot use. Similarly, we cannot use 5 also, because there is no multiple of 5. If we use 5, we can make this product multiple of 5 and this one multiple of 5. But we cannot make this product multiple of 5 here. So we cannot use 5 also. And similarly, we can eliminate 7 because we are not having any multiple of 7 also. So all 3 products cannot be multiple of 7. So now we left with 7 digits and 7 letters. We have to use all these 7 digits to make sure this product is valid. So we have to use definitely 9 somewhere. So if we put 9 here in the first product, it means second product and third product also has to be multiple of 9. We can see Q is common between first product and last product. So we can put Q is equal to 9 here. Now first one and last one, both of them are multiple of 9. So we have to make sure second product is also multiple of 9. But we cannot use 9 here. So we have to use other numbers to make sure this particular product is multiple of 9. So we have to use 3 and 6 together. So we use 3 and 6 together. Now all the products are multiple of 9. Now we have to use 8 somewhere. So we have to use 8 somewhere. So we have to put 8 here. If we put 8 here, this particular product is multiple of 8. Now we have to make sure this product is also multiple of 8. This product is already multiple of 2. So if we put 4 here, this product becomes multiple of 8. Now let's last one, if you see, we have to make sure this is also multiple of 8. So we can write down 2 into 4. Now all the numbers are multiple of 8. Now we left with only one digit and one alphabet. We can put 1 here. So that's how we can see all the products are equal and product of the given numbers is equal to 72. But this is not the only possible case, because 9, 9 is common here because of Q. Similarly, YY is common here because of 4, right? So we can replace these digits. It means Q can be 4 and Y can be 9 here. If we do so, let's see, Q is equal to 4 and Y is equal to 9 here. Now, these numbers has to be multiple of 8. When this number has to be multiple of 8, we can write down this is 8 here. And similarly, we can write down this is 1 here. Now this number has to be multiple of 8. It means A has to be 2 here. And finally, we can write down this number has to be multiple of 9 and 8. So we can put 3 and 6. We can also write down 6 and 3, because P can be 6 and R can be 3. But product will remain same, which is equal to 72. So if we follow a systematic approach, which we have already discussed in previous 2 case lists, you can see how easy this question is to decode. So let's move further and see questions based upon this particular case list. So if we see the questions based upon here, the first question is, what does letter A represents? You can see in both the cases A is representing 2. So right answer for the first question is B here. Look at the second question. If letter Q represents 4, that means Q is representing 4. We are looking for first case here. If Q is 4, then what is P representing? P can be 3 or P can be 6 as we discussed earlier. So answer for this question has to be E, which is either A or B. Look at the third question. Which three digits are not represented by any of the 7 letters? We know the answer for this question is C. Look at the fourth question. What is the value of P into Q into R, which is 72? So right answer is B. And finally, if X represents 8, so when X is representing 8, it means they're talking about first case. So when X is representing 8, what is the value of Q? Then Q is fixed. Q has to be 4 here. So right answer for this question is A. So all the 5 questions we solve very easily after decoding the given caselet. So I hope you understood how to start and how to decode these caselet. Thank you so much. Thanks a lot.